Hello everyone, I welcome you all in this tutorial series. In this segment we are going to discuss about objective types of questions. They are used on semiconductor knives as well as on semiconductor devices. So we have the first question. The conventional current in a PN junction diode flows. Now we have four options. The first option is from positive to negative terminal. They have given is the first option over here. Second option is from, there is a small correction here. It should be negative, from negative to positive. So just putting it here. This is negative to positive. Third option we have in a direction opposite to the electron flow, and the last option is given as both AMs. So as far as the conventional current in PN junction diode is correct, we have seen this portion. We have a symbolic representation like this, where we have this as anode and this as cathode. So the direction of current is always in a way like this. So if I connect it with a positive terminal and negative terminal of battery, so you can see it here. This is positive terminal and this is negative terminal. So current always flows from positive terminal to negative terminal. So our option A becomes correct, whereas the second option will be wrong, from negative to positive. Now we have the third option, in a direction opposite to the electron flow. Now see, we have seen a PN junction diode. So here we have P-type semiconductor and here we have N-type semiconductor. And we have seen in case of forward bias, where we have connected positive terminal to P-type semiconductor and negative to N-type semiconductor. Now, P-type has holes as majority charge carriers, whereas N-type has electrons as hole as majority charge carriers. So we have seen that the flow of electron will be like this. Now, how actually the flow of electron takes place, like this one. So for that case, this is positive charge and positive charge. So they will repel each other. So this will be the movement of holes. Similarly, negative, negative, again, so you can see it here. They are again negatively charged, so there will be a force of repulsion, so there will be a direction of electrons like this one. Now if electron flows in this direction and current flows in this direction, so the schematic becomes, this is the direction of current and this is the direction of electron. So our option C is also correct. So based on that, the best option will be option D, both A and C, from positive to negative and in a direction opposite to the electron flow. So our option D is dear students. This question has asked in many of the competitive examinations, so we have to be more cautious about this one. Now we'll move on to the next question. The cut-in voltage of silicon, SI stands for silicon, is, so we have four options: 0.2 volt, 0.7, 0.8 and 1.0 volt. Now what is cut-in voltage? Cut-in voltage is also called as, we know that, we'll take a pen over here. The cut-in voltage is also called as knee voltage, and we have seen its values also. For silicon, the typical value will be 0.7 volt, and for germanium it will be around 0.3 or 0.2 volt. So here our option becomes B, the cut-in voltage of silicon is 0.7 volt. Now we'll move on to the next slide, and here we have energy gap decreases quick. Now this is a question related with energy band theory that we have studied in case of lecture number 3. Now as you see energy bands, so basically we have a conduction band which is denoted as EC, and we have one more band which is called as valence band, whose energy is EV. And in between this, whatever the space is there, this space or this energy gap is called as energy gap. Now when I increase the temperature, more number of electrons from valence band will move towards conduction band. So as we go on increasing the temperature, the energy gap goes on decreasing, and therefore our option becomes B, temperature increases, energy gap decreases. Ab hum isko agar remember karna chahte to kis tarah se kar sakte. So we have the values of energy gap. Energy gap for conductor is 0. Energy gap of insulator is 6 electron volt, whereas energy gap of semiconductor was around 1.21 volt electron volt and 0.785 electron volt. तो आप देख सकते हैं, if you increase the temperature, energy gap is almost to zero, and when you decrease the temperature, the energy gap increases, and therefore they are inversely proportional. Now you have to remember these values also, because you may expect a question on these values also. We'll move on to the next question. The question is, when a diode is reverse bias, it is equivalent to. Now we have the option. It is equivalent to off switch. It is equivalent to on switch. It is equivalent to a high resistance or none of the above. Now friends, we have seen two cases. One is when a diode, that is PN junction diode, is forward biased. So we have positive negative terminal. This schematic is called as forward bias. Whereas if I connect p-type semiconductor to negative terminal and n-type semiconductor to positive terminal, this term is called as reverse bias. Now during forward bias, we have seen current conduction takes place, that means current flows in a direction like this. Whereas in case of reverse bias, no current flows. Now if no current flows, definitely it will work as off switch. It will work as what? Off switch. And therefore our option A will be correct. When a diode is reverse bias, it is equivalent to a off switch device. Okay, now reverse, when a diode is forward bias, it works as what? On switch device. Okay, so this is the answer of question number 5. I hope you are getting the questions. Now next is, when forward biased the diode is. Now we have four options. I will simply note this as the question and these are the options. So during forward bias, the diode blocks the current. It has a high resistance, it conducts current, but drops a large voltage. So we have seen this in the earlier question. When the diode is forward bias, it conducts the current, or it supports the conduction of electricity. Therefore, option C is correct. We'll move on to the next slide now. Now, next question is, a PN junction diode dynamic conduction is directly proportional to. What is the question? A PN junction diode's dynamic conduction is directly proportional to. So we have four options: applied voltage, applied temperature, current, and thermal voltage. Now friends, as far as PN junction diodes are conduction, their dynamic conduction is definitely dependent on what, or it is directly proportional to temperature. As the temperature goes on increasing, more number of electron becomes free, and therefore conductivity goes on increases, and hence option B, remember option B is the correct option for dynamic conduction. Next question we have, junction background of a PN junction occurs. What is the question? Junction breakdown of a PN junction occurs with forward bias, with reverse bias, manufacturing defect, none of these. Now as far as the forward bias is considered, so we have seen that, we have seen the characteristics also. I will draw the characteristics for your understanding. So friends, we have two operation modes. One is forward biased voltage and forward current IF, always in milliampere. This is reverse voltage and this is the reverse current. The reverse current is very small, in microamperes. So as far as the forward characteristics are considered, so up to 0.7 there is a small change in current, and after 0.7 there is a sudden rise in the current. This is forward bias. Whereas in case of reverse bias, after a particular voltage there is a sharp or sudden increase in the current values, and this particular increase in current value is called as what? Breakdown. This is called as what? Breakdown. And this occurs in which condition? It occurs during reverse bias. So our option becomes with the reverse bias. There is nothing to do with manufacturing defect, In forward bias, junction breakdown doesn't take place. None of these option is not suitable. So we go with reverse bias. Option is correct. Now we have the next question. Reverse saturation current in a silicon PN junction diodes doubles for every. Now they are given the first option, 2 degree rise in temperature, 5 degree rise in temperature, 6 degree and 10 degree. So remember, as far as reverse saturation is current or reverse saturation current is considered, so the option for double or just doubles for every 10 degree rise in temperature will be the correct one. Remember, for every 10 degree rise in temperature, reverse saturation current goes on increases. Now reverse saturation current, it denoted as IR, its value is very small, it is in microampere, okay, and this takes place in p-type semiconductor as well as in n-type semiconductor or the combination of p-n junction diodes also. So it increases for 10 degree rise in temperature. Important question, we have to remember these values. Similarly, we have the next question, the conductivity of germanium. What is the question? The conductivity of germanium increases 4 degree rise in temperature. In terms of percentage they have asked. So the options are 8%, 6%, 10% and 12%. Now here the option which is the most correct one will be option number B. That means the conductivity of germanium increases for 6% per degree rise in temperature. Per degree rise in temperature. Now exactly reverse, if it is asked for silicon, it will be 8%. It will be 8%. Remember, for germanium 6% and for silicon it is 8%. Now these questions were asked in the IAS examinations also, as well as in gate examinations and multiple state level examinations. So that question you can expect. Now this question was asked in 2011 or 2017 MPSC examination. The question is, diode is unilateral circuit element because it can conduct current in both direction. This is the first option. It can conduct current in one direction. It is unsymmetrical in fabrication. And last option is its power rating is low. Now let us first concentrate on the word unilateral. Unilateral means only one direction. Remember, unilateral means one direction as far as current direction is concerned. Now as you know that in forward bias condition, the current flows in one direction, and as far as diode is considered, it allows the current to flow in one direction, and therefore our option becomes the second one. As it can conduct current in one direction, diode is called as what? Unilateral circuit element. Okay, unilateral circuit element. Again, remember, during forward bias, it acts as switch, that is on switch, and during reverse bias, it acts as off switch. And due to off switch, no current flows, and during forward bias, current flows to the circuit. Okay, so this is about this question. This was asked in the MPSC examination. We'll move on to the next question. I hope you are getting those questions quite correctly. If you like the video, please subscribe to our channel as well as share the video. Now we have the next question. In any atomic or in any atom, the number of electrons in the last orbit is limited to. Now this question was asked in 2011 MPSC examination. Now friends, we have seen this in case of atomic structures. So we know that a last orbit is basically called as valence shell. Okay, so in case of valence shell, we know that maximum 8 electrons can be received. Okay, how many electrons will be there? 8 electrons will be there. Therefore, our option becomes this one. That is 8. Okay. Now, why 8? Just check the video. We have seen maximum number of electrons will be 2n square. Yes. I can just note it down over here. Max electrons in any orbit will be 2n square. So as far as the first orbit is considered, we have 2 electrons. In second orbit, 2 square 4 into this 8, then we have 18 and so on. So the feasible option for here will be 8, because the remaining are 12, 10, 4, like this one. So here it will be 8. I will go to the next one. Next question is, semiconductor devices has a negative temperature coefficient, a positive temperature coefficient, exponential, none of the above. So as far as semiconductors are considered, they have a negative temperature coefficient. Remember, they have a negative temperature coefficient. Whereas if I consider metal, or we call it as conductor, so all metals or conductor has positive temperature coefficient. Now few things we have to remember. Metals, as we know that they are a good conductor of electricity, so they have a positive temperature coefficient. And semiconductors are moderate, therefore they have a negative temperature coefficient. So option A is correct, negative temperature coefficient. Next is, at room temperature, the current in an intrinsic semiconductor is due to. Okay. Now we have seen what do we mean by intrinsic semiconductor, extrinsic semiconductor. So as far as the intrinsic semiconductor is considered, intrinsic semiconductor, we know that the intrinsic semiconductors are basically insulators at room temperature. And there is no doping element involved in this, due to which the current, whatever constitute, it will be due to both holes and electrons. It will be due to what? Holes and electrons. So our option C becomes correct, due to holes and electrons. Okay. Now, with this question, we have a reference also. We have extrinsic semiconductors also. Extrinsic semiconductor. Now, we have seen the extrinsic semiconductor, we have two types. One is called as P-type extrinsic semiconductor and the other one is called as N-type. So, in case of N-type semiconductor, electrons are majority charge carriers and in P-type, holes are majority charge carriers. So, extrinsic semiconductor, N-type, electrons will be the current carriers and in case of P-type, holes will be the current carriers. But for intrinsic semiconductor, both holes and electrons constitute the current. Now you have to be just as good as with this one also. Now we have the next question. Current flow in a semiconductor is due to. Now, as far as semiconductors are considered, basically whatever the current flows, it flows due to two mechanisms. One is called as drift. One is called as diffusion also. Okay. Now, what is drift? What is diffusion? Drift current flows due to applied voltage. Due to what? Applied voltage. And diffusion current flows due to gradient. It flows due to the gradient. Now, sir, you may have the question, sir, what is gradient? What is applied voltage? So, I will give you the hint. Okay. Now, as far as the PN junction diode is considered, we have seen during forward bias, what happens, sir? So we have a positive terminal and negative terminal. So positive is connected to P-type, negative is connected to N-type. Now, as we go on increasing this particular voltage, more number of holes will be flowing in this direction due to force of repulsion. More number of electrons, again they will be pushed here, sorry. More number of holes will be repelled over here due to force of repulsion. So they will cross here, electrons will cross here, yes. And due to this, whatever the current is constituted, this current is called as current. Okay, so as we goes on increasing the applied voltage, more number of electrons becomes free, more number of holes will be in combination, and due to this, drift current takes or it occurs. Now, when I go across diffusion current, what happens, sir? So in case of diffusion current, if you simply place P-type and N-type semiconductor with each other, we know that P-type has holes as majority charge carrier, N-type has electrons as majority charge carriers. Now what happens? We know the force of attraction. When a positive and a negative ions are close together, there will be a force of attraction. So they will attract with each other. Similarly, this will collide, this will collide and this will collide. So these electrons will be in combined state. Now this occurs due to majority charge values, and whatever the current is constituted due to this phenomena, this current is called as diffusion. Now if you see drift and diffusion, in this case recombination of electrons and holes take place. So are all options are correct, due to drift current, due to diffusion, due to recombination. So the best option will be all of them. Current in semiconductor due to what? All of these. Okay. Now based on that, you may get a question around about drift current as well as about the diffusion current. Drift current is due to applied voltage, diffusion current is due to gradient or the gradient terminology. I hope you are getting it. We'll move on to the next. Yes, favorite question for all of us is the band gap of silicon at 300 degree Kelvin. You have seen the band gap, energy gaps values also. So for silicon, it is 1.10. And for germanium, do you know the value? It is around 0.75 something electron. So by the way, just I believe it is this term. Our option will be what? Option number B, that is 1.10 electron volt band gap of silicon. We will move to the next question. We have the next question as a PN junction diode dynamic conductance is directly proportional to. Now in the earlier question we have seen dynamic conduction, now here it is dynamic conductance. Conductance, I will tell you, conductance is inversely proportional to resistance. What is it? They are inversely proportional to each other. Generally it is written as G, and our resistance, we know that it is written as R. So G is inversely proportional to R. So it is directly proportional to what, sir? Temperature. It will be directly proportional to what? Temperature. So in earlier case, we have seen that it is inversely proportional. Yes, but it was resistance. And now here we are dealing with conductance. So conductance is inversely proportional to resistance, and therefore conductance is directly proportional to what? It is directly proportional to temperature. Next question, please. So we have the next question number 18. The video is becoming lengthy, but I hope you are enjoying it. We have the next question. Which of the following is not associated with a PN junction diode? Important question hai. Dekhiye iska answer kya ho sakta hai. So where they have given the first option as junction capacitance, second as charge storage, depletion capacitance, and channel integration. Now sir, even if you don't know anything about PN junction diode, if you observe the options, where the first option junction capacitance, second charge storage, and depletion capacitance. That means these three options are related with the capacitance, and this is channel length modulation. So definitely the answer will be channel length modulation is not associated with the PN junction diode. I repeat, channel length modulation. Now why channel length modulation? Because channel length modulation is a part of FET, that is field effect transistor. That part we have to see in the later portion. So as far as field effect transistors are considered, channel length modulation comes into picture. As well as or for PN junction, it is junction, charge and depletion capacitance. Now our next question, the reverse current of silicon is due to, important question is sir, silicon reverse current is due to what? Highly biased, voltage sensitive, highly temperature sensitive, both, and last is independent of biased voltage. Dekhiye sir, humne dekha tha, reverse saturation current, it flows due to the temperature. Yes. So as you go on increasing the temperature, what happens? The minority carriers, I repeat it here, the minority charge carriers, this supports conduction. This supports what? Conduction. And as this supports the conduction, whatever the current flows, this current is called as reverse saturation. And definitely they are dependent on what? Highly temperature devices. Therefore our option becomes the second option as highly temperature. Okay, or they are dependent on the temperature itself. Friends, so the last question, I hope so. So now we have two questions left. So the next question is the value of N for silicon is. Now The question arises, sir, what is N? So basically N is nothing but Nita. Nita. We have seen that equation. If not, go and check the video where the question has, the current equation has I is equals to I naught e raised to V by Nita Vt minus 1. So this Nita has a specific value. So for the silicon, Nita value was 2. We just put it down here. Silicon, Nita value is 2, and for germanium, the Nita value is 1. Now they have asked us for silicon, so definitely the answer will be second option. The value of Nita for silicon is 2. Okay, last but not least, question is the value of thermal voltage. The value of thermal voltage for diode at 300 degrees Celsius is. Now sir, again, what is thermal voltage? So just recall the same equation, the other equation, current equation I is equals to I naught e raised to V by Nita Vt minus 1. Now here V is nothing but applied voltage. We don't have to consider for this. Nita we have seen 2 or 1 value, and Vt is basically what? Thermal voltage. Thermal voltage. Now this value will be fixed, and the value is 26 millivolt. What is the value? 26 millivolt at 300 degree Kelvin. Okay sir, so see, these values we have to remember. Why? Because you basically belongs to mechanical engineering, so you have the depth of mechanical syllabus, but as far as electronics and syllabus, just remember those factors. Okay. So I hope you understood those 21 questions. The number is also good, 21. Maybe you expect one of the question from this diode section. If you have any questions apart from this, you just post it there. I will try to answer it. Okay. Thank you very much for joining this session. If you are liking this video, please hit the bell button as well as subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much.